Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Frontierland. And ladies and gentlemen, there's our last ride of the evening. The Mark Twain Riverboat. Hang on, get around that.
Very good.
Tonight, this will be our last ride of the evening. Tomorrow, I can't say, I am hoping to do Splash Mountain both times, as well as another Laughing Stock Christmas, which I hope you guys enjoy, this time inside Walt's booth. And so Frozen from the Resonate section. And then it's all about the ending. All right, guys, let's make our way on board the Mark Twain. Oh, it looks gorgeous this time of night. And unlike the train, where we saw very limited, here we actually see it all. We see it all. And oh, wow. We actually do get a view of the... We actually do see somewhat of a view of the flares over there. Now, does this mean the set's going to end once before we take off again? It's going to remain to be seen. All right, guys, I'll see you guys in just a moment. Once they all get off the boat. All right, everybody. Looks like we're about to board the Mark Twain Riverboat. Our last ride of the evening before I head out of here for the evening, before I get another round of this tomorrow.
I'm sorry, folks, we're going to be loading from ride here. So watch your fingers, watch your toes as they open the gate. And when you come on board, please watch your step and help any children on board by holding their hands.
Oh, that's... All right, all right. Now, you guys know where I'm going. And up. Fail. And up. Okay, I have to go around. Okay. That is weird. That is weird. I have to walk around. And I have to walk around. That is an epic fail on not epic proportions. Here's your crown, here's your dime, here's your... Alright. Now we got a good view of the jazz band over there. View of that jazz band over there. And I could totally see us having a big Legends get together for the here on the riverboat for the nighttime spectacular. Of course, this is probably where Fantastic would be. Bring your bike, yeah.
Chicago!
Here we go!
Passengers aboard!
Time to say adios to... Here we go! Take her away, Admiral! It's time to shove off! Dun, dun. Turn off the music now. Thank
you. Bowman, cast off bow line. Engine room, ahead 1/4. Engine room, ahead 3/4. Ledsman,
there's a thing for Fantastic.
Bow door.
By the walk. Bot one. That's the Ledsman calling out the depth marking so we can avoid running aground.
Mark Twain!
Mark Twain is not just the name of a riverboat or a great American author. It also means the water here is 2 fathoms deep. That means it's safe enough for us to proceed on our steam-powered journey along the rivers of America. On our trip, we'll visit the magnificent Columbia of the Great Northwest, the graceful Missouri of the windswept plains, and the rugged Rio Grande along the border of Texas and Mexico. I'll be sure to point out interesting sights along the way, and even tell you about a legend or two. We begin our trip
there's
right here on the
I may want to do a nighttime ride on that.
Heading south,
potentially tomorrow too, actually.
Down in New Orleans.
Potentially tomorrow to Southland. city, way down on the river, where the women are very pretty, and all the men deliver. Hear what I'm saying, make your fever all right. Ride somebody, come on down. Bring your paintbrush, we paint the town. Let the season go around. Dash you down in New Orleans.
New Orleans is rich in history, music, good food, and ghost stories. One of those stories involves the old mansion you see over there on the hill. I've heard it said that the place is haunted, filled with 999 ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And they're looking for one more to make it an even 1,000. If you're brave enough, you should see for yourself after we arrive back at the landing in Frontierland. We're now passing Fowler's Harbor. This is home to the three-masted windjammer, the Columbia, the first American ship to circumnavigate the globe.
Nighttime riding on
Here's a bit of
Wayne.
History for you. The Columbia set sail for Boston Harbor in 1787. She grounded in port and became the first American ship to carry the stars and stripes around the world. The most famous landmark in this area is Splash Mountain, named for the fact that everyone seems to have a splashy good time when they visit. Splash Mountain is part of Critter Country, a remote wilderness filled with tall pines, rustic buildings, backwood bayous, and one of those tall tales of the New Orleans. The story is that the birds and animals that live here can talk, sing, and dance.
They didn't wave. How rude. There's the canoes and a hooray! No, follow up. Tried. Here's my L.
While you're in Critter Country, you might want to grab a paddle and try your hand at the Explorer Canoes.
Good luck in this one tonight.
You'll have a real good sweat rowing one of those around the river. Me? I'll take the comfort of the Mark Twain Riverboat any day.
Thank you. And there's that third pathway to Galaxy's Edge. And I will say, that definitely really opens up the area really nicely. And now, here we go, everybody. We're now entering the backwoods country. I'll win a serious train! Here we go, stand by for the train. Ward Kimball. So Ward Kimball is the one we missed.
Peaceful.
Doing up a pound of peace over there.
Off to the side of the river is an idiot. And I do believe he's giving us a sign of peace. That means we're all clear as we head up the Missouri River to the home of the Plains Indians.
Doesn't help that we're near the plains. We're near the... We can still see the Plains of Galaxy there. There's the cat we saw earlier. New for this year as well. The old one got demoed. And now we're going to get the first shot of Kevin Dunn.
Yay! That is good! Yeah, I want to use that guy live! Before you and David Calvert! David Calvert! Well, I'm just going to enjoy this piece of food!
On the port side of the riverboat is a wide old shaman, sharing the story from all of us to you. He's telling the tale of how a woodpecker taught young tribes
to take a hollowed out branch
and turn it into that most wondrous of musical instruments, the flute.
Wow.
It's a legend the Lakota have passed down from generation to generation.
Man, I wish my friends could ride this. If I had friends.
And then, just beyond the shore, is a tribe of friends. Setting up their camp along the banks of the river. They'll be there for a few months.
More like several years. Wow. They did, I will say, they have done a truly phenomenal job with the lighting on here with the camp. And with Dick Thunder in the background, you could totally...
As we continue our journey, keep a close eye on the riverbanks. There's a good chance we might catch a glimpse of moose, mountain lions, and other wildlife.
That turned out phenomenal. And now, as we approach the end of our trip, and more importantly, the end of our day, here at Disneyland for today, I would just like to say, even though we've done a lot today, the rainouts earlier this year really affected my performance. And I will just have to say thank you guys so much for all the support. It truly does mean a lot. But you guys chose to support my channel.
Off the starboard side is Pirate's Lair at Tom Sawyer Island. Young Tom always said he wanted to be a pirate, and I think I see why. If you're a pirate, you don't need to get up early in the morning and go to school, and you never have to wash your face and hands. All you have to do is just look for treasure all day long. At least that's what Tom Sawyer thought.
Yeah, man, it's so creepy to see the island up close. Well, time to head below decks. As we begin our closing procedures at I forgot. Well, that's all right. No matters. We can just go down this way. And, wow, did a great job. Minus that crane in the background. Let's make our way down below decks so we can go ashore. Before I can go home and get ready to do some Animal Crossing. And even the plaque seems to have got some TLC. Somewhat.
We're now heading back into civilization along the Rio Grande. Off in the distance are the towering peaks of Big Thunder Mountain. Rumor has it that the railroad built to haul gold out of the mountain has been seized by supernatural forces.
Supernatural, my foot. Okay, I'm just kidding, y'all.
Of course, that may be just another legend of the river.
Just ahead is Frontier Land, where our journey begins. On behalf of our entire crew, I'd like to thank you for booking passage on the Mark Twain Riverboat. At this time, we ask that you prepare to disembark. If you're on one of the other decks, please make your way down to the first deck. The stairway to the right side and the back of the boat may offer the quickest and easiest route. We hope you enjoyed your voyage with us and that you'll visit us again real soon.
Alright, here we go.
Engine room.
Say goodbye.
Approach ready at 1/4 speed. Man for the line. All passengers, stand by to
go ashore. Yeah, the Kings win 4-1, baby. And by the way, I would love this. All right, everyone. I'll see you guys in the sign off. All right, everybody. That's pretty much gonna do it for our show tonight. We'll be back here tomorrow for an awesome dance off, as well as some rides and. Ladies and gentlemen, look at this. The Garlands are back for the first time in 3 years. And, boy. I have forgotten how cool the park looks at Christmas. Alright, if you guys enjoyed today's show, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on Twitter at twitter.com/MikeFromLA. Like my Facebook page at facebook.com/MikeFromLA regarding my schedule and everything. And whether I'm at WWE events or not. Happy Skype Banjo, subscribe to my Daily Motion account just in case something goes horribly, horribly wrong. Well, I guess that's it for tonight, guys. Good night, and I'll see you guys tonight for Animal Crossing. If not, I'll see you guys tomorrow.